Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, with another in the series on the 1857 phone autograph. Getting ready to power smoke some paper here. I have my mask handy. I don't know if you can tell, but it's actually beginning to turn black. So there's a lot of this stuff spewing in the air. Maybe I should start a new channel, Benjamin J. the Coal Miner. And the stuff is getting everywhere. So anyway, I've devised a new way or a quicker way to do this. And I no longer adjust the lamp. I leave the lamp adjusted where it is. And now that the wick is burned and saturated, this thing just cranks. I mean, it just absolutely spews soot. As you see, once it gets going, so we slide it under the paper. I'm wearing a mask, obviously. So, I had hoped I was going to find some easy, simple, modern solution to doing this. And I tried paints, primers, anything you could possibly think of that you could just spray onto this paper and do the same thing. Unfortunately, I never found anything. I spent, I don't know, probably a couple of weeks testing this. And anything that left a mark took too much pressure with the stylus, which killed all of the modulation, so it was pointless. So the only way to do this is the original way. And this is time consuming. I'm going a lot faster now than it was when I first started. Of course, now I'm learning how to do this, adjusting the lamp correctly. And like I said, as you can see, that's just spewing carbon. That is not smoke. That is pure carbon. So you have to do this every single recording. And that's what takes so long. And you can't do it off the mandrel because there's no way that you can touch this. I mean, literally a hair will make a line in it. If you touch it, you just wipe the carbon right off the paper. So it has to be done on the mandrel. But it's going a lot faster than it originally was. And I can't turn the lamp any higher. If I turn it any higher, the soot will actually combust and a flame starts coming out the top of this thing. But I haven't had a fire or anything like that. Haven't scorched the paper yet. Of course, this mandrel that this paper is stuck to is made of brass, so it's sucking away a lot of the heat really quickly. So, but still, it's slow, tedious. I don't know how toxic this stuff is, but I would not want to do this without a mask. And I'll probably be changing this one tonight. So I'm going to be doing some recording, so I'm going to be doing a lot of this tonight. Alright, almost done. And really the nice thing about doing this is you can really adjust and control where the soot is going. So if you see a little blank spot, you can just go over and hover over it for a second. And it just erases it. Okay, that is completely coated with carbon. So now without turning the lamp down, I just blow it out. That way I don't have to adjust anything. The next time I use it, all I have to do is light it. And it makes that amount of carbon every time. It's just spewing carbon. But as you see, it is making a really, really nice uniform black coating on this paper. Hard to believe this is a piece of white typing paper. It's actually 8.5 by 14 copy paper. So, just wanted to do a quick video. Going much faster than it did. So, learning as I go. So, just wanted to do a video on speed blackening the paper for the 1857 phonautograph. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email. TheVictrolaGuy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.